For more reaction now, I'm joined by Karima Brown's former colleague, Ryland Fisher. Ryland, thanks for your time. I hope you can hear me. Of course, you worked with Karima quite closely previously. Before we get to the hard-hitting journalist that she was, let's talk about her early days in this field and why she got into it in the first place. What did you guys speak of?
Sean, so I've known Karima for almost 40 years. I met her when she was a young student who lived in Westridge in Mitchell's Plain, and she became a member of our local branch of the Cape Youth Congress, and I was part of the leadership of CAECO at the time. From the time we met, I mean, Karima was always one who questioned everything and gave us a hard time sometimes in meetings. And so when she decided to become a journalist, it wasn't a surprise. And I think she took those two things into a journalism. The incessant questioning, and then also the struggle background, the political activism, which was really based on kind of wanting to uplift the poorest of the poor in our society, wanting to change the country into a better place for the majority of people in our society. And I think those two things kind of drove the journalism. And so while she was never really shy about the political affiliation, her political affiliation was never driven by loyalty to a political party or political personality. It was driven by this desire to make a difference to society. So yes, I mean, I still remember this young Karima Samar, who lived in Westridge, came to our youth meetings and gave us a hard time in our meetings.
And she didn't stop.
It was good.
She didn't stop giving people a hard time, didn't she? Especially when it came to politicians. Yeah. So what kind of?
I think that's one of the things.
Carry on.
No, I'm saying that's one of the things that a lot of politicians don't understand is that kind of part of a good journalist is that you must be able to ask the difficult questions. And she wasn't shy to ask the difficult questions. And of course, that kind of meant that there were lots of people who kind of, you know, had views about her and who just liked her in a way because of that. But she was doing a job, and she was doing a darn good job.
Yeah, brilliant job, many people will argue. There are some people, as you say, who have criticism, especially during this time, which for me is despicable, to say the least. But let's talk about that. You can't be a favorite of society when you are going to argue with politicians when it comes to the truth, can you? Because ultimately, what Karima was trying to do was hold people accountable, especially when they were elected into power by South Africans.
Yes, and I think, you see, the thing is that politicians make this mistake of thinking that anyone who questions them has a kind of a political agenda or some kind of, you know, factional agenda and so on. And I don't think that was the case with Karima. Karima was the same Karima, whether she questioned, irrespective of kind of where the person was politically, like Patricia DeLille said now, you know, you could be in this faction of the ANC or that faction of the ANC, or you could be with the DA or with Good or any other political party. She would treat you in the same way, and she would kind of question you in the same way. And if you try to spin, she would question you again until you kind of, you know, spin yourself into a corner. And that's what good journalism is supposed to be about. That's about finding the truth on behalf of the people that we are representing. Because ultimately, journalists are asking the questions on behalf of the public. And so we need to do our job properly and ask the questions properly, because otherwise we are not doing our job correctly for the public.
Yeah, I can tell you that I have definitely had many lessons from Karima Brown, which was always encouraging. Thank you so much for your time, Ryland Fisher, the former editor of the Cape Times.